Welcome to another week of preseason Ironman training. Welcome back. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Chris. We are prepping for Ironman Arizona 2024 in November, specifically November 17th. And this is the series where I document my life, document my training leading up to that race to ultimately PR Ironman Arizona come November. It's the beginning of March at the moment, and we are in a preseason block where we are focusing on strength training and building up a strong base again. Because this year, I have plans on improving on my time based off of 2 years ago when I did my first Ironman in Arizona. I really need to be focusing on getting my strength back because the bike portion of that race does have a bit of climbing, and it does require to have a strong foundation of legs. And we got a little bit of rolling hills on that race as well for the run. And it's just gonna require a overall strong frame that I need to be building up right now here in the preseason. So if you watched the vlog from last week, I mentioned that we are going to be hybrid training throughout the whole duration of the year. So right now we are working on building strength, squats, deadlifts, bench press, you know, CrossFit endurance workouts. We're doing a little bit of cleans on the weekends, basically building up the strong foundation that I had in previous years and really making that a primary objective to be strong this year. So that's the goal. And then also to building up that aerobic base again. So right now we are doing about 3 to 4 bike rides a week. We're doing 2 to 3 pool sessions a week and about 3 sessions of running per week as well. So that's the plan as we continue to build and taking you guys along the journey with me. Wrap off tonight, we are doing 50 minutes on the bike. It's gonna be staying at a steady 120 watts. Same workout as last week where I'll mix in a couple sets, single leg, pedal. But other than that, it's just zone 2, 50 minutes. And that'll be it for the night. There we go. Tonight I am using Erg mode, so I don't have to worry about changing gears. And this motor will just set 120 watts. Don't have to worry about any gear changes or anything like that. I could just focus on finding a zone and getting dialed. All right, right now we're about to hit a set of single leg pedaling, but because I'm on erg mode, I gotta do this quick or else I'm gonna lose the feel and the tension's gonna tighten up really quick on me, so. All
All right, we got about 10 more minutes, 8 more minutes, and that's a wrap.
Busy, busy day ahead of us. We have a project to finish with Whoop, where I need to grab 3 still photos. I'm trying to think the best way to shoot it, because I do shoot on a video camera. I think the best way to do this is to shoot in 120 frames per second, 4K as a video, try to set up the best shot as possible, and then we'll grab a screen grab of the best still within that video. As far as training goes, what I did yesterday was I flip-flopped Tuesday's workout with Monday's workout. So we did Tuesday's yesterday. We did a run, we did a bike, we lifted. Today, we're gonna lift again, and we're gonna hop in the pool later. So Mondays, I typically will hop in the pool, but just the schedule of my day yesterday, it made more sense to do the bike and run yesterday and do the swim today. So it also fits pretty nicely too, because I do like to squat on Mondays. Cybertruck. Oh my God. That was wild, bro. That was fucking crazy, bro.
All right, let's get this workout in. Today we have an upper body day. For the strength, we're starting out with bench. Typically on most of my workout days, what I'm doing is I'm having multiple strength days. So Monday's squat, Tuesday's bench, Wednesday will just be bodybuilding or recovery or focus on triathlon training. Thursday will be my deadlift day. Friday, I like to do body weight stuff. So I like to hit the rower, like to hit the skier, like to hit the assault bike as a way to get active recovery in. Saturday or Sunday, maybe doing some Olympic lifting, some cleans, some hang cleans, power cleans, really focusing on the explosiveness. And then aside from all the strength, I'm hitting bodybuilding stuff. I'm hitting some Metcons, etc. So that's typically what I'm doing right now. And that's kind of the foundation I've always had. So for today, we're hitting bench press. And typically for strength right now, we're doing 5x5. So not really trying to find any new PRs or anything like that. I know my strength is gonna be lacking just a bit because, of course, the primary focus is still triathlon training. So I'm not really worried that I'm not hitting any crazy PRs. Just as long as I can feel strong, that's really the main goal. Let me get out of these running shoes. Yesterday we hit squats, some lunges, hit the rower, hit some dumbbell deadlifts, some step ups. Not gonna lie, I do feel pretty sore today. Not like crazy sore or anything like that, but I definitely feel it a little bit. So I'm gonna really make sure after this upper body workout that I stretch in the sauna. Open up the glutes, open up the hips, and then later tonight we have a swim. So kind of hoping that any built up lactic acid will kind of drop off over the swim workout. So we're gonna warm up right now. All right. So I don't go too heavy for my working sets. I'll put a couple warm-up sets. This is kind of low. I don't know why this is so fucking low. whatever. Yep. Nope, that's not gonna work. That's too fucking low. When you're doing bench press, you don't want to be re-racking it and unracking it from down here. It's pretty difficult. You want to get as close as you can away from you so that once you unrack it, you're just already in position. So like something like this. It's like a perfect height. Way better. So this is kind of shitty, but as we're building out this gym, you can only get so many pieces at a time, and one piece that we're lacking right now is 10s. I picked these up initially thinking that they were 10s, but these are in kgs. I believe that's like 22.5 pounds. So I definitely need to pick up some 10s. I need to pick up another set of 45s. And I'm really thinking about, you guys haven't seen those Nike recycled plates. Man, I'm thinking about getting some of those. Those just look so dope. Maybe get a Nike bar as well. But we can only build out this gym so quick. So this might feel pretty heavy. But let's give it a go. Another thing I'm really making sure I'm doing with bench is getting a tight back. Make sure that my scap is tight. I've got good grip on the ground. And I'm good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright. Felt pretty heavy. So that'll be my working weight. That'll be set one. So we're about 185 right now. And we'll hit that for 5 sets of 5. And then we'll hit the rest of the workout. So once the strength is over, then we hit some Metcons. And then after that, we hop in the sauna. All right, this is set number 5 right here. I'm not gonna lie, that last set, I didn't film, by the way. I did not film that. It was pretty difficult. Set 3 was pretty easy. Set 4 was hard. Set 5, I can feel it a little bit. Yep. All right, up next, we're gonna hit some seated shoulder press. 8 to 12 reps. I'm gonna stay right at 10. You know, I think instead of shoulder press, I'm gonna hit like a Arnold press. I do wanna hit a little bit of, you know, mobility within the shoulder movement. So I think a nice Arnold press kind of works that mobility that I'm looking to hit, so. To 12 reps, probably hit anywhere between 8 and 10 is the goal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. All right, the next movement is dumbbell lateral raise. Be seated. All right, for this last little set, we're gonna hit 10 rows each side. We're gonna hop on the skier, hit 10 calories, and then hit 10 neutral front raises.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
It is fucking freezing, but for the main work, we got 12 by 75 yards. Let's go.
One thing I'm working on right now is making sure my head is neutral and not looking forward, and that helps me get a stronger pull.
Yo, my head feels flat. That felt fast.
What are we having for dinner?
Dude, for 15 minutes.
All right, we just completed the warm up. We have a 10 minute cool down right now. And then we got the main working sets. For the main working sets today, what we're doing is muscle tension activation. So 190 watts between 50 to 60 RPMs, which is really slow, really focusing on that muscle activation throughout the legs and glutes. And we got 8 sets of that for 30 seconds with a rest, and then repeat one more time. We got about 7 minutes left and this little cool down of the warm up. And then we're off to the first set. Ah. 17 miles, 57 minutes. Solid workout. Now, time for dinner.
Yes, sir.
Before we dive in though, we need to test our metabolism with Lumen. I've been using this device for 5 years now. I was an early backer when this was just an idea. And I gotta say, it's one of the most innovative products I've ever seen in quite some time. Basically, what it's doing is you breathe in, hold, breathe out, and with that data, it's able to tell you if you're burning carbohydrates or burning body fat. Before this ride, I blew a 4, which means I was burning 75% carbs, 25% body fat. I did carb up a little bit before the ride, so it was expected. And now we just spun about an hour. So I'm assuming I burned off some of the carbohydrates. So I would assume I'm either a 3 or a 2. So the lower the number, the more body fat you're burning. The higher the number, up to 5, is more carb dominant burning. So I believe I'm probably gonna be somewhere between 3 and 2. What do you think?
2.
Oh no. The intensity wasn't that high today, but it was a pretty challenging workout. So let's see.
Exhale in 3, 2, 1.
Damn. Still a 4. But I'm burning less carbs than I was before. 65% carbs, 35% fat. So heading in the right direction, but intensity wasn't quite high enough today to deplete the glucose out of my system, but it's all good. Time to eat. For Din-Din, we are having steak, asparagus, and a baked potato. Gonna be drinking some poppy root beer. Freshly made by the one and only.
Welcome to Thursday. It's already in the evening. It's been a busy, busy day. Taking care of a few things around the apartment, taking care of some work. Now we gotta start our workout. We're gonna hop on this treadmill. We're gonna hit 50 plus minutes on the treadmill. If I have time, I'm gonna squeeze in the strength session for today, which is deadlifts. If I don't have time, I'll just do it tomorrow. It's not a big deal. But first and foremost, I want to crank out the run, and then I will hop in the sauna regardless as well. Let's stop wasting time. Let's get this run.
We could spray like a natural fragrance in there.
Whew, what a beautiful day. What a beautiful day. Welcome to Friday. Last day of the week. Gotta finish it strong. A couple more workouts to do. A little bit of a run. A little bit of a swim tonight. But another solid week, man. Another solid week, making good progress. Getting leaner, feel like we're getting leaner. I also feel like we're gaining muscle too, which is nice. Which was kind of the main goal for this year, so.
You know, and that's gonna translate into Ironman training. I'm gonna get stronger, I'm gonna feel better. As strength training progresses, we're just gonna have to stay on top of, you know, making sure that we
are staying limber as volume picks up from Ironman training, but we're making a lot of progress, so that fires me up.
Now, I know a lot of you might have some base knowledge on how to edit already, and you might feel like you don't need to watch some of these modules, but my recommendation to you is to watch everything from start to finish. Just like Texas, I got
today we have a 2-hour ride and we are gonna fuel up. I'm gonna show you my exact fueling strategy to get through today's ride. First things first, before we do that, we need to test our metabolism with Lumen. See if we're burning carbohydrates or if we're burning fat right now. And that'll give me a good understanding of how to fuel for this workout.
Exhale in 3, 2, 1.
This morning we're burning a 2. So that tells me we're 75% fat burning, 25% carb burning, which tells me that we need to for sure carbohydrate up for this bike ride. So I'm gonna fill all 3 bottles with water. Each water represents 1 hour. Because we're riding about 2.5 hours today, I'm just gonna fill 3 up just to have a little bit of a reserve. And that's what my bike holds. So let's fill these up. So because I woke up at 2, this is actually gonna be an interesting test to see how my body carbs up and what it does post-workout. So the way we're gonna fuel for this workout is we're gonna go 75 grams per hour. So we're gonna go 3 scoops. And then we're gonna leave this last bottle just water. So we'll be intaking 150 grams for this workout, which should be plenty of carbs. And raw fuel also has sodium in it. It's got 300 milligrams of sodium, 1-to-1 sea salt to sodium citrate ratio. So we're all taken care of. So we'll do 1 bottle per hour, and then we'll have this leftover to kind of sip on a little bit.
All we ever had was the block, bro, we down and raise each other. Never let them break up the game, we gotta stay together. However, I see that they planning, I'ma play it better. You know that we all that we got, so we gotta stay together. San Fran ain't doing nothing, you love us, send a letter. Know I'm going over the top for you, I pay whatever. Ain't no stopping, I'm all in, you know I gotta get them. The world got a whole lot to offer, you gotta live a little. Some shit I can't figure out, and I'll probably never get it. Man, Slime got great understanding, and I'm forever with him. Forever with him. Man, Slime got great understanding, and I'm forever with him. Forever with him. Man, Slime got great understanding, and I'm forever with him. Forever with him. Man, Slime got great understanding, and I'm forever with him. Forever with him.
Took nothing to something, I took the time out to let them dividers just struggling and never found out who. I called a vision in Saudi, it's like a hideout. I make a move in the morning, fuck it, let's ride out. Them Lamborghinis be scriding on any corner. Ain't really nothing I had, nigga, you know I ain't lying. Keep your money in front of you, I had to tell the little homie. You stop believing these hoes, you had a time of your life. Mask on out in public like you ain't never know them. Pills turned them to zombies, now they forever rolling. How many times you ain't wanted, then they tell you what you gonna do. Had to dip off from London, I had too many that night. Fuck your favorite rapper, his number ain't even numbers. Fuck your latest designer, this that new Yeezy come up. Bet the car guy turned milk chocolate to peanut butter. Niggas claiming they called me, ain't even had my number. In the midst of a storm and you see me standing on him. He gon' handle that for you, now you forever on. Fuck the head of the company, I'm the better owner. Y'all put hurdles in front of me with bananas on them. Then you wonder why April go bananas on them. Protect your hair from this burn like it's tanning lotion. See, we started all hustling and we ended up balling. I had to follow my calling.
Lunch, we're having a steak sandwich, but before we eat, we're gonna retest on Lumen to see where my metabolism is at. I'm not gonna lie, I do feel pretty depleted right now, so probably still gonna be like a 2 or a 3. I doubt I'll be anything more than that. I did consume about 100-ish grams of carbs on the bike ride. Any guesses?
Anyone? Any guesses? Two? Anyone else? Two? Over there?
Three.
Three? It's a three. That's about right. I'm cool with that. That works with me. Time to eat.
Okay, okay, okay. I'm about to have a good day. No matter what they say.
Welcome to Sunday, the Lord's Day. We have eggs and bacon. Since I took an off day on Friday instead of today for the swim, we're gonna have to swim after breakfast, but for breakfast we're having eggs, bacon, potatoes.
All right, for today's workout, we're ripping 12 by 75 yards and then 12 by 50 yards after that. Again, for this workout, really keeping my head neutral is the biggest mental cue for the session. And by keeping my head neutral, it's gonna allow me to keep my elbow high, get a good push through the water. Sometimes I feel like lately my elbow might be dropping a little bit, and keeping the head neutral can kind of reinforce and keep that elbow high to get a good push of the water. So that's the main goal for this workout. 12 sets, 75 yards, and then 12 sets, 50 yards. Let's go. All right, 12 by 75 is complete. Not gonna lie, man. I feel like my form is dialed, but my muscle endurance is not quite there yet. I'm getting fatigued a bit on the 75 yards, but my form feels pretty dialed in. That just comes with time as my body gets more and more accumulated to the volume, but good thing is, form is there. That's a wrap. Solid workout. 1,500 yards. Felt good. Another solid week in the books. All right, to wrap off this week, we are gonna do a bit of a Metcon. No weights or anything like that, but what we're gonna do is the skier, the rower, and the assault bike. So what I'm gonna do for this workout is we've got the skier here, we've got the rower here, and we've got the assault bike right there, back to back to back. And what we're gonna do is have a goal of 100 calories per station as the main goal. Where we're gonna get creative is I get to choose how many calories I wanna do at a time and strategize as I go. So I've been thinking a little bit about it. I'm either gonna go 10, 10, 10, or I maybe even will do like 50 calories on the skier. This is gonna be a fun workout. So this workout will just be for time. I'll run a running clock, and the goal is to hit 100, 100, and 100. And then we'll actually do some sit-ups behind me on the GHD, and then we'll finish off in the sauna, and that'll be a wrap on the weekend. It's gonna be a fun workout. I don't know. So my strategy for that workout, I started off with 50 calories on the skier, 50 calories on the rower, and then I did 20 calories each on the bike. So by the time I got to the bike, I knew that I needed to do 5 sets of 20, and then followed by 10 calories back on the skier, 10 calories on the rower, 20 calories on the bike. The only switch up I did was on the 4th set. I busted out 30 calories on the bike. So that led me to the 5th and final set being 10, 10, 10. So I was able to sprint on the bike. And we finished at 24 minutes, 15 seconds. That was a tough workout. That was fucking tough. But anyways, about to hop in the Sisu, get some recovery. That pretty much wraps up this week. A lot of planning I gotta do tonight for like brand partnerships. For the month of March, and there will be a little bit of a surprise in next week's vlog that's coming tomorrow, so stay tuned for that. But other than that, that's a wrap, guys. I'm beat. I'll catch you guys on the next vlog. Make sure you like, subscribe, comment. Another week down in the books. See you guys on the next one. Southside, do or die, Shot Town, top 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Who am I? Yay.